What do you want to play today? What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Thanks so much for being here. I know there's other places you go, but I really appreciate you joining me, hanging out today. Today, we're going to play Poppy Playtime 2, Chapter 2, on the Xbox Series X. It's finally out, Chapter 2 and 3, so I can finally get caught up on my story. I previously played Chapter 1 on the Nintendo Switch, so if you haven't seen that video, go ahead and check it out. But, of course, since it came out on the Xbox, I picked up all three chapters. And I can't wait to play Chapter 2 and Chapter 3 because I'm going to be playing them for the first time. Haven't played them yet. My kids have played them on Steam, and they love them. So I was waiting for the console because I'm a console guy and couldn't wait for it to come out. So now it's finally out. So we are going to play it for the first time ever. So drop a like for Poppy Playtime 2. Drop a like for Mobber and Tamer for finally coming through with the console port. And let's go.
With Playtime Co.'s new patented elastic plastic, you can stretch, pull, and twist Mommy Longlegs in the craziest ways. She loves watching you play. When you're having fun, she's having fun. The new Mommy Longlegs from Playtime Co. What's the time?
Wake up. Playtime Co. is the product of a great man by the name of Elliot Ludwig, divorced but a family man at heart. His sights were always set on bringing amazing toys to amazing children around the globe. Ludwig spent countless hours in the factory, working overtime relentlessly in an attempt to continuously innovate and surprise. In the 1960s, an unfortunate family death had pushed Ludwig down to his lowest. But with so much ambition, he rose back up and continued to fulfill his vision for the Playtime Co. Toy Factory. Ludwig could never be content leaving a project unfinished. But just how did one man come to create such an astounding empire? How did he manage to stay determined even after suffering such a tragic loss? It all began in the fateful year of 19...
Listen, I'm going to need you to trust me.
Insides while you're still alive. station. I'm Stella, and we've got three super-duper fun games to play. Little tests show us just how crazy strong and smart you are. Follow Mommy Longlegs down the stairs, and we'll start by playing Musical Memory. See you in a bit.
I know when your birthday is! June 28th! make a wish.
Welcome to Musical Memory. This advanced memory and cognitive recognition test is designed to stimulate several segments of the brain, allowing us to see how quickly and efficiently your brain works. A sequence of colors will be shown, and you must recreate the exact sequence using the buttons around you. Bunzo will slowly lower towards you. When you complete a color pattern correctly, Bunzo will rise back up. When you input a pattern incorrectly, Bunzo will lower towards you faster. If Bunzo reaches you, your test is over. The test will become more difficult as it continues, with longer patterns in quicker succession. That's all. Good luck.
Heart. J, Lenda, Massive, Violet, J, Violet, Morgan, Yellow, Omega, Massive, Lenda, Violet, Morgan, Blue, Snow, White, Heart, J, Rebbe, Heart, Red, Y, Flames, J, Red, Green, Blue, Blue, Red, J, White, Purple, Earth, and the Color, Smart, J.
Oh, it broke. That's no fun. For doing such a splendid job, Mommy has decided to give you part of the code for the train. Look up. Take it. Mommy was hoping the game could last a little longer. It's okay, though. Mommy knows other ways to play with you.
Wanna hear a dino joke? Click once for the question, click again for the punchline.
Thank you. Yeah.
know when your birthday is. June 28th.
To be this smart. Mommy is super proud of you, but I'm sure she's already told you that herself. Our next game is Wagga Wuggy. Head downstairs and have fun.
Welcome to Wagga Wuggy. This advanced test is designed to assess the extent of your reactionary abilities. A dual palm grab pack will be provided to you for this test. Around you are 18 sizable holes. An adorable Huggy Wuggy toy could appear out of any one of these holes. If one comes out, hit it with your grab pack. That's all. Good luck.
The toys in this game used to have strings attached to them so they could be pulled back when they got too close to the children. Have fun.
Mommy has another hint for you.
I was hoping you'd stay here forever. Though, it's never too late to change your mind.
I said no more!
Thank you. So, Marcus, what happened?
You see, I was heading home for the day when my A-Pars realized that I left my bloody wallet in the cafeteria. So I'm running through the lobby, and that's when I see it. A mop handle lodged under the innovation wing gate.
So what'd you do, Marcus?
Well, I just thought I'd nab the bloody yoke and be on me merry way.
And?
Well, I'm reaching for the thing, and the mop handle jolts on its own. Had me scared stiff. I thought I was the only one there. So I took a peek beneath the gate, and some massive bloody thing was dothering about the bloody hallway.
Thing? You're sure it wasn't a person?
Ain't no person that's 50 feet long with 1,000 legs.
Marcus, you're losing me. Maybe you just saw a bunch of people walking by.
Look, it wasn't people, all right? I haven't a bloody notion what it was, but it wasn't human.
Who have you told about this? Besides me, obviously.
Just you, sir. Obviously.
Okay. I'll have security skim the cameras and take a look.
What? There's a massive bloody monster! Skimming ain't gonna get rid of it!
You're out of line, Marcus. We make toys, not monsters. Now come on, get out of my sight. Actually, grab me a coffee, will you? Actually, never mind. Get out of my sight.
played these before? You're so good! Seems like you're ready for the final game, statues! Follow Mommy down the stairs one last time. I hope you had a fun day at the game station. See you next time!
You want to play with PJ?
Welcome to Statues. This advanced obstacle course is designed to test your physical endurance and strength. The rules are simple. The lights will turn off. You can move through the obstacle course at this time. However, when the lights turn on, you can look around but cannot move. You may move again once the lights turn back off. The lovable PJ Pugapillar will follow you. If PJ reaches you, your test is over. That's all. Good luck.
It was always so sad to see the kids go. They called me Mommy because I was the closest thing they ever had to one. But they'd come for games and never come back. They left Mommy to die alone. Mommy didn't deserve that. But you worked here. So if anyone deserves to die alone,
thank you. going to play one last game. It's called Hide and Seek. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Thank you. make me part of him! You can't do this to me!
Log code 08502. In relation, experiment 1006, the prototype. A close call occurred this week in which he nearly breached containment. The prototype seemingly disassembled the digital alarm clock within his room and utilized the battery, along with several other components, to create a laser pointer, which he then fired into the security camera, disabling it. These actions allowed him 28.3 seconds completely unmonitored. Once function returned to the camera, the room appeared to be empty. One surveillance specialist went in to confirm his absence. However, upon opening the door, she realized that the prototype had hidden in one of the camera's blind spots. The prototype attempted to escape through the open door. However, another surveillance specialist was able to remotely relock the door, despite the other specialists still being inside. One casualty occurred. The prototype seems to possess an unprecedented level of intelligence beyond that of all other test subjects, as well as an alarming willingness to commit violence. Further suppression treatments will need to be enacted to ensure that no other experiments develop these qualities. Experiment 1170, Huggy Wuggy, remains the optimal outcome due to his sufficient intelligence paired with maximum obedience. End of log.
you kill her? Good. I'll board the train. We need to leave. back in that case. But you saved me. You are perfect. Too perfect to lose. I'm sorry. I can't let you leave. I've never met anyone like you. Do you know how long I've been stuck in that case? Well, too long. I had so much time to think and reflect. Time to figure out exactly what I would do when free. We'll set things right. Terrible things have happened. But I know that whatever I need you to do, you're capable. We will. What if...